In the name of Allah, Assalamu alaikum everybody, my name is Abdurrahman Turkman Sina and I hope all of you will be fine. Today I am going to show you how to use multiple operating systems into one single computer. Multiple operating system means how to use many operating systems into one computer, just like Windows 7, Windows 8, Windows Vista, Windows XP, even Mac operating system into one single computer. So to do that, we're gonna need a software by the name of VirtualBox. Actually, we can also do this by using VMware Workstation. But VMware Workstation has a limit of usage. It has when you download it from its website, it will give you for 1 month to use. After 1 month, it expires, and it needs a software key. And software key, you need to buy the software key. But the VirtualBox is a freeware, completely, totally freeware, freeware software, and VirtualBox is something in which you can install multiple operating systems. So, all right, to download VirtualBox, just open up your web browser and type Oracle VirtualBox. Oracle VirtualBox. So click on the first link. Then click on Downloads. So here you see, here you have four options to download. If you are using Windows operating system, just click on first link. If you are using Mac OS, just click on second link. If you are downloading this VirtualBox for Linux, just click on this link. If you are downloading VirtualBox for Solaris host, just click on this. So I'm using I'm currently using Windows, so I'm going to download it for Windows. Just click on that. If you want to download for Windows, just click on that. I'm not gonna download because I already have it. So after you download, you must download VirtualBox extension pack 2. To download VirtualBox, just come this link, and just remember one thing. If you are downloading VirtualBox 4.2.6 version, just your extension pack must be same with same version. So to download extension pack of this VirtualBox which is version is 4.2.6, just click on this. So I'm not gonna download it. If you want to download, just click on save. I'm not gonna download it. So after you downloading the VirtualBox, just install it in your computer as commonly. So after installation VirtualBox, just open up. When you open a VirtualBox first time, there will be nothing will be showing up. Mine one exists there, Windows 7. So first thing you're gonna do is installing extension pack which you have downloaded earlier. So just click on file and click on preferences and extensions. As you can see, mine one has already installed. You will be different. There will be nothing showing up by the name of like this extension pack. To install VirtualBox extension pack, just click on this button which is add packages, and find your extension pack wherever it is, wherever you have downloaded that. So then once you have opened that, there it will give you a message to install. Just okay to install. Then your extension pack will be installed. What is extension pack? Extension pack is something which gives us access to access of USB to our VirtualBox. So Just click on OK, and now I'm going to install Windows XP into my this VirtualBox. So VirtualBox is something as I mentioned earlier. VirtualBox is something in which you can install multiple operating systems. So now I have already installed Windows 7 into my VirtualBox, and now I'm going to install Windows XP into my VirtualBox. So one more thing. I personally use VirtualBox for educational purpose. It's up to you on which way you use VirtualBox. So just click on new to create new, and then give your operating system name. In my case, I'm going to use Windows XP. Windows XP. Then type, choose Microsoft Windows, and then version Windows XP. Choose whatever you want. I'm giving you example Windows XP. You can use whatever operating system you want in this list, in which is listed here: Windows Vista, Windows 7, Windows 8, other Windows. It's up to you. So in my case, I'm using Windows XP. So click on next, and then give your virtual machine's name. I'm going to give it this operating system RAM 192 MB. Its recommended size is this 192 MB. So then just click on next, and then next create, and then make sure you have checked this VDI VirtualBox this image. Then click on next, and choose dynamically allocated. Then next, and now here. At the first box here, it's the location of your virtual machine, wherever it's located. You can change it by this choose a location. So, and now here is in the second part you can give hard disk of your virtual machine. I'm going to give it 10 GB. It's okay for me. So then click on create. So once you have done that, just come to settings, just wait for it, 100% complete. Okay, then click on system. Then your base memory, you can use it up to whatever you want. It's okay for me, 171. So then display, video memory, you can use graphic up to 128 MB. So storage, audio, network, just do not touch anything else. So just click on OK, and now click on start. And at this point, if you are using a Windows XP ISO image, just click on this little button. And if you want to install your Windows XP from CD, just click on this. Choose your CD DVD drive. In my case, I'm installing from my DVD drive, which letter is G. So, I'm going to choose host drive G, and then click on start. And now installation has begun. Actually, this video takes a lot of time. This video takes approximately 1 hour. I will skip useless points just like this. I will try to make it as shorter as I can. So in this point, I'm going to pause the video. It's up to you. It's Windows XP installation. If you want to make drive, just click on C. If you want to create partition, if you want to install whole of all of your this partition, just click on enter. I'm going to install. I'm going to have just one drive into my Windows XP, so I'm going to enter to install. So here is the formatting options. So I'm going to format the partition using the interface file system. Okay, so setup is formatting. Here it says press any key to boot from CD. Do not touch any key. Now this window should pop up. Here it says setup will complete in approximately 39 minutes. Just wait for 39 minutes to complete. So now this window pop ups. Here it says license agreement. Just accept this agreement, click on that and click on next, and now our installation will continue. And now here it says setup will complete in approximately 37 minutes. Just wait for it. So here it says type your full name and the name of your company or organization. So just type your name or whatever you want. Mine one is MP, and then click on next, and then give your computer name. So once you give your name, type your password if you want. If you don't, click on your computer will restart, and then you will be able to use your computer. So I'm gonna pause the video again at this point because it's a waste of time. Okay, then click on next. Help protect my PC by turning on automatic update now. Just click on it and then click on next. Skip. Type your name. Finish. So, we are almost done. And now, we need to do a few things. First thing you're gonna do is installing guest edition. So, as you can see, here comes a question. If you want to copy, here comes a question: how to copy from files to this computer? As you can see, if I copy my this files, copy, and I want to paste it into my virtual machine. You cannot do this by like this. To get access files which is located into your original computer, just you need to install guest editions. To install guest edition, just come to device menu and then click on install guest edition. After installing guest edition, you will be able to use your virtual machine full screen. As you can see, if I maximize my virtual machine, it does not show me full screen. So here it says software installation. Here it gives you alert. Just click on continue anyway. So now installation complete wizard comes up. Here it says you must restart your computer now. So just click on reboot to restart your computer, not your original computer, your virtual machine which you have installed. Just click on finish to reboot your computer. Just wait for its reboot. Okay, now after installing guest edition, you will be able to see your virtual machine full screen, and also you will be able to share your files from your original computer to your virtual machine. And now we're gonna share our files from our original computer to virtual machine. So to do that, just click on device menu and then click on shared folder. And then click on this button, add share folder, and then choose your folder path. Click on this other, and then choose your folder. In here as you can see, you can choose a whole drive. You can choose whole drive, and also you can choose a folder which you want to share with your virtual box. Now I'm going to share all my D drive with my virtual box. By doing this, I will be able to use my files which is located in D drive into my virtual box. So just choose your folder or D drive you want. Click on OK, and then here our folder name D drive has been shared. And now here is three options. First one is read only. The second one is auto mount. The third one is make permanent. You'd better choose make permanent. Make permanent means if you choose make permanent, each time you restart your virtual machine, this drive will be automatically shared. Then click on OK, and then click on OK again. So now what you're gonna do is just click on my computer and right click on it, right click or come to tools and choose map network drive. Just click on it and then choose your drive later, but you'd better choose the drive which is default. So then choose your folder which you have shared earlier. Click on browse and then virtual box share folders. And then choose your folder which you have shared earlier. So just select that and then click on OK. Here you choose the folder or drive which you have shared. Click on OK and then check. Make sure this box is checked. Reconnect at logon and then click on Finish. And now you can see my D drive has been shared. Complete. Now I'm able to use my D drive things. As you can see. Okay. Now folder sharing has been done, and now how you can access you can get access to your USB flash drive, and how you can use your USB flash drive into your virtual box. So I have a USB flash drive. As you can see, I have USB flash drive into my original computer, but it's not showing up into my virtual machine. As you can see, I don't have USB flash drive here. To connect your USB flash drive into your virtual box, just click on devices menu and then click on USB devices, and then you are choose your USB flash drive. And in my case, mine one is Kingston Data Traveler 4GB. Just click on it. Just let it install the driver software. And now, as you can see, I can use my my USB flash drive into my virtual box. Let's open it. This is the file which is located in my USB flash drive. So now the next question is when you come to your USB flash drive, there is no. And the next question is, as you can see, I have a CD drive into my original computer, which is something like this. And here I have CD drive into my computer, in which I have something like Windows XP installation CD or whatever it is. And now here it's showing up into my original PC, but it's not showing up into my virtual machine. To get access into your CD or DVD drive, just click on devices menu and then CD or DVD devices, and choose your CD drive letter. In my case, my name is G. I'm gonna click on G. And now, as you can see, I'm able to use CD drive. So that's the end of it. I hope you'd enjoy my video. If you have any question, just let me know in the comments below. Thank you for watching my video. See you on my next video. Until then, Allah Hafiz and goodbye.